The horrific events in Highland Park, Illinois on the 4th of July brought contortionism from some in conservative media, blaming everything except easy access to lethal firepower for mass shootings. Here's a sampling.
The authorities in their lives, mostly women, never stops lecturing them about their so-called privilege. You're male, you're privileged. Imagine that. Try to imagine an unhealthier, unhappier life than that. So a lot of young men in America are going nuts. Are you surprised?
In the mass shooting in Illinois, indications are that Robert Cremo was a regular pot user. Now, one look at him, and to the untrained eye, he looks like a complete psychotic. Have you ever seen anyone looking like him? And what can regular pot use trigger in young men in particular? Psychosis and other violent personality changes. Not everyone, but a significant percentage.
Police had seized weapons from his house, including swords and guns, and officials in Illinois still didn't stuff this kid into a straitjacket. Anyone with facial tattoos and a track record like that is screaming, please put me in an insane asylum.
Women, marijuana, facial tattoos. Some conservative politicians are diverting as well, apparently. They cannot bring themselves to explain why the country needs the kinds of killing machines favored by mass shooters.
I think yesterday's shooting is another example of what the problem is. The problem is mental health and these young men who seem to be inspired to commit these atrocities. So I think the bill that we passed targeted the problem.
For the record, the bipartisan gun bill did not include any regulation of assault weapons used in so many of these mass shootings, or it would have not passed by its slim majority. And joining us now with more is Paul Waldman, a progressive liberal opinion columnist with The Washington Post. Hi, Paul. So you wrote this op-ed that was a springboard for this conversation. You say you think it starts with cognitive dissonance. Explain.
Well, cognitive dissonance is when you have two ideas or beliefs that come into conflict. And that's what happens every time there's a mass shooting to people who are advocates of unfettered gun rights, right? They don't want mass shootings. They don't want people to be killed. But they also favor the maintenance of a legal regime that makes that possible. So whenever anyone is confronted with cognitive dissonance, you have to find a way to resolve it. And so in their case, they resolve it by coming up with all kinds of reasons why the guns have nothing to do with the fact of the mass shooting. And I think that it has gotten sort of ratcheted up recently. You know, we heard there Mitch McConnell say, oh, it's mental health. And that for a long time has been this kind of standard response from Republican politicians. Now, there's a couple of problems with that. First of all, for the most part, they don't really favor putting a lot of more resources into mental health in general, because they're conservative and they don't think it's government's job to provide a lot of social services. And so you often find the same people saying, oh, well, the real problem is mental health, when in fact they don't actually support expanding mental health services. The other problem, of course, is that there are people with mental health problems everywhere in the world. It's not like we're the only country that has people with mental health problems. The difference in America, of course, is the guns. And I think that even among Republican politicians, they've gotten ridiculed for making that argument so much that they're a little bit more reluctant to make it, or at least some of them may be. You find, especially in conservative media this time around, these kind of more elaborate and extravagant arguments about how it's something else. It's not the guns, and it also happens to be whatever that TV host's particular hobby horse is. So, you know, we see with Tucker Carlson, he's been on this crusade about the decline of masculinity, and he has this special where people seem to be advised, men seem to be advised to tan their testicles, that's going to restore their manly vigor. And so he blames it on women who are nagging and men who don't feel like they're masculine enough. And Laura Ingraham has been on a long crusade against marijuana, and so for her, the problem must be marijuana. Whatever it is that you're already mad about and is your particular kind of the thing that gets you angry, that's what must be to blame for the latest mass shooting.
And it's interesting because these elaborate explanations featured in conservative media, they are intended to provide the base with arguments, but they don't actually need to make sense, right, to resonate with people.
Yeah, and I think that's something important too. You know, especially if you're in kind of a something of a media silo and you get all your information from one side, you know, maybe you don't actually have a lot of occasions to get into a real substantive argument where you're really trying to persuade somebody else. You know, maybe at Thanksgiving you're a 70-year-old Fox News viewer and your 25-year-old niece is there and you get into a fight with her and you're the two of you are arguing. But most of the time, you know, you talk to people who kind of think like you, and you watch media that where your ideas are reinforced. But one of the things that the media do whenever there's a new controversy is they tell us kind of how to think about it, and they also tell us some arguments we can even use just when we're speaking to ourselves. And I think that in a situation like this one, where if you're a supporter of gun rights, you know, you see on a daily, weekly basis more and more mass shootings, and you really might have doubts about whether this particular system that you're in favor of is actually a good thing or is hurting a lot of people, you need something you can tell yourself. And if it's not all that persuasive, that doesn't even matter. What matters is that when there's the next mass shooting, you can say, oh, well, you know, obviously this just shows how we have too much marijuana, or that there's this crisis of masculinity, or that people aren't paying enough attention to mental health and somebody just needs to set these kids straight. Whatever it is, you need to have something you can tell yourself so that you don't begin to kind of panic and question your own beliefs and therefore, you know, question the whole system under which you're living and the people that you like and the politicians you like have created.
Yeah, well, it's so much a part of your identity, right? All right, Paul Waldman, thank you. Really interesting conversation.
My pleasure. Thanks.